Developed by McDonnell-Douglas at St. Louis, the F-15 is considered by many to be the greatest fighter ever. Two F-100 turbofan engines give a takeoff thrust of around 25 tons, which is more than the clean gross weight. As a result, the performance is spectacular. As soon as the wheels leave the ground, you can haul back on the stick and point the nose straight up. Within 3 or 4 seconds, the rate of climb can exceed 50,000 feet per minute. The F-15's wing is crucial to its maneuverability, and it gets its power mainly by being very large. Wing area exceeds 600 square feet, which is about the size of a medium bomber's wing in World War II, and 3 times as big as a typical World War II fighter. The wing's lifting power is so great that the latest version, the F-15E, can carry not only a huge load of fuel, but also a bomb load of over 23,500 pounds. The maximum loaded weight of the F-15E version is 81,000 pounds, which is heavier than any World War II heavy bomber and 10 times as heavy as a typical World War II fighter. Despite this, the F-15 has fantastic flight performance with a top speed 2.5 times the speed of sound. Unfortunately, it also needs extremely strong and level paved runways. And the Air Force has belatedly begun to wonder how it can keep its F-15s flying if their big and vulnerable bases should be destroyed by enemy air or missile strikes. Often, and especially in Europe, NBC exercises are mounted in which all personnel wear the uncomfortable protective clothing intended to enable operations to continue in nuclear, biological, or chemically contaminated environments. NBC exercises, though vital, are seldom popular, especially on a hot and humid day. Even when wearing the protective clothing, all personnel have to be able to carry out their allotted tasks, both outside on the airfield and also within hardened aircraft shelters. Once the shelter doors are closed, the aircraft can be repaired, refueled, and rearmed, ready for another mission. All NATO airfields are being equipped with similar blast-proof shelters. Regular deployment to Europe of F-15 units, normally stationed in the US, such as these from the 1st Tactical Fighter Wing at Langley, Virginia, enable both pilots and ground crews to familiarize themselves with the problems of operating from frontline air bases. Though the aircraft handling techniques may be similar, there is an added sense of danger. It is also particularly important in the event of a scramble to get as many aircraft into the air as fast as possible so that they are not caught on the ground by an enemy's preemptive strike.